Here we go, the boss fight. I've been getting destroyed in for the past few attempts. I'm gonna try to focus on this fight. I can't really spot. Just know the green boss is his tank. That's a terrible start. Ugh. I'm trying not to use a lock-in because it gets so buggy in this fight. Bro, he used the green dagger and used the vacuum on me. It ruined my movement. I hate you! What do I do? I need to check my cooldowns. What do I have? Paralyzed? No, there. Here's a little payback. Here. Now then. So every time he does the fork, oh, never mind. Yeah, every time he does the fork projectile, you don't want to roll to the side. Otherwise, you'll end up getting the debuff that can eventually lead to a freeze. It's horrible. See, the moment I just roll to the side, I just get frozen and get beat up. Oh, only hit up for 20%. Here's a little payback. I think I lost this run too. Now I'm just wondering if I should kill the Earth Dragon. Maybe. It's hard to tell which projectiles he's throwing. The fast one is like a straight ball. The slow one is the fork. Tanking for him. I'm like straight up getting zoned out by this green dragon. I might just kill him for my next run. He deserves to die first. Yeah. gonna try it next game. So Blue Dragon 3 working with mechanics. So I have to keep an eye out the Green Dragon and avoiding this mechanic. So this is how it feels when I'm zoning out the bosses. Feels bad.
You reap what you sow.
You reap what you sow. You're right about that. Definitely a problem. Character with so little mobility.
Here's a little payback. Have a face full of
auto targeting is just kinda is rough in this fight specifically. I think I might have found the pattern with the Blue Dragon. Figured him out, but nope. This is a tough fight.
Power. Your time's up. zap. Here. Here's a fun trick. You reap what you sow.